strip the prayer down in Jeremiah 12:5. Now, you don't preach it. I'm just adding down to it, all right? I found what's in Jeremiah 12:5. And God gave an answer to people because they were wondering about a race.
Yes.
Somebody say amen? Amen. And whenever you're in a race and you got a question about God, God will give you answers.
Yes.
So the prophet Jeremiah, he prophesied,
right,
as you did today. Somebody say amen?
Amen.
He said, Jeremiah said, if you have a race with men on foot and they have worn you out, how can you compete with horses?
Jesus.
Somebody say amen?
Amen.
I'm in the race of living faithfully, living holy.
Yeah.
And praise God, you let mankind run you out.
Right.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
What you gonna do when the real trouble comes? Let me read on here. I'm gonna finish here, right? So as you stumble in safe countries, how will you manage in the thickets by the Jordan? Lord, have mercy here. The prophet said, amen, as he was saying, the prophet said, if you, amen, get in trouble where you think you're safe,
come on.
Oh, come on, somebody.
Amen.
What you going to do to get in the thickets?
Yes.
What you going to do to the cattle when everybody's picking on you? What you going to do when your job don't work out?
Yes.
What you going to do when you feel like relationships are not coming your way?
Yes.
If you're in the church now, praise God, you're barely making it now, and you're crying out,
amen.
Some of them want to trust God now. Ain't nothing going on with you. Ain't nothing really bothering you. You're not that sick. You're not that broke. Come on, somebody. So God said, you can't trust me now. You can't run no race now. What you going to do when it really get bad?
Yeah.
Oh, that's what I'm saying. Amen. Amen. Bad yet, prophet. It ain't been that bad yet for some of us. And we're just a crying, no, what I'm gonna do. It's so like old Nick O'Shea, what we just gonna do? Amen. But God said, the same mother, if you can't run in the same place, what you gonna do when you get in the thickets?
What you gonna do?
What you gonna do when it get hard? I'm talking about really hard.
Yeah.
When people don't like you, they ask you just because you go to church.
Come on.
Yeah.
When they get mad at you, since when you don't go where you used to go with them.
Yeah.
You won't give them the right.
Amen.
You won't borrow the money.
Yeah.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
You go in your house, take stuff that you know ain't God, and you begin to pour it out and throw it away.
Amen.
And they get mad because you won't bring and give to them.
That's right.
Amen.
Y'all hear me here today. So the Bible said, what you going to do? Brothers, when you make that call and they don't want you to come.
Mm.
Or sisters, when they call you and they get mad because you want them to come there no more.
Yeah.
What you gonna do when you get lonely and everybody else got somebody and you crying about what you ain't got?
Yes.
Amen. Somebody come in for that today. But you in a race. Somebody say amen. So the prophet said, what you going to do?
What you
going to
do?
And mankind run you out. What you going to do with horses come on with you? So what the man of God says, you're in the race.
Come on now.
And you're winning.
Yes.
Stop complaining.
Yes.
Amen.
Keep on going forth.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Are y'all feeling me today?
Amen.
That was a powerful word today.
Powerful word.
You gotta get, like the man God said too, you can't, once you cough that, you gotta get in a position.
Yes.
See, some of us in the church right now, amen, you can't even start the race because you gotta get in a position.
Come on, Apostle.
Amen.
Come on now.
And you hold it, listen, let me, I just caught this. I'm like Apostle. I'm like my mom now. I just gotta download.
Yes.
You know, in a race where it said get in a position,
that's right.
If everybody's not in the right position, the man can't fire the gun.
Can't fire the gun.
Come on.
You gonna hold
somebody else back.
Amen.
Somebody here wanna run.
Jesus.
Yeah.
Somebody here picked up with a run. They better get started. But see, if you up there messing around, somebody say amen. You won't play, you won't come about study, you won't come to Sunday school, you won't get active in the church, you don't want to do nothing for it. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
And when others do it, you get mad because they're doing it.
Yes.
What you wanna do, they say, get in the right, get in position.
Yeah.
So we at least some of you won't even get a position. You still walking around. I don't know. I'll challenge today. I don't feel it today. I don't know. Every Sunday you hear you go. We trying to run.
Come on now.
Oh, the king. We trying to get. We want to break the star. We want to run. Here you are. I don't know. Maybe I don't know. I don't feel God. I don't know.
Amen.
We want to run.
Yes.
Jesus.
And I'm gonna say this, then I'm gonna take my seat. We want to build our front.
Yes.
We want our bathrooms up front.
Amen.
That's the race.
Yes.
That's improvement. It's gonna cost us something.
Yes.
But you know why we can't get it done? And we do that, I don't know. What are you gonna call? We gotta make some sacrifices. I don't know. Come on, in the block. I'm like, come on, guys. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
All right, y'all. Listen, someone's a quick apostle. You need your time, man. Quick. But listen, y'all. You heard a word today. Let's honor God. God bless you, sir. Amen. God bless you, sir. Amen. Yes, we need to get in the place. And you got to get in position, y'all. Because, see, God want to bless us.
Yes.
But, see, he can't hit the gun and start the race.
Everybody get in position.
Amen.
Amen. And it can't be no false start. We all got to start together.
That's right.
See, the problem is, in this race, see, we want to get our front done. Here we go. Thank you, Lord. Another download. Some of us have started. But they gotta go to, whoa, come back. Come back, false start. False start.
Come on now.
Come back. And see, we had a mindset, but one time we were shouting and jumping and we were speaking about the front and but see, God don't call back to a lot of now like, ain't them on the bathroom, the back, just fix them up, nigga. Let them walk through.
Amen.
See? And see, you keep false starting and holding us up, you know what they're going to do like they do in the real races?
Disqualify you.
Amen.
They're going to put you out.
Yes.
Somebody say amen?
Amen.
They're going to put you out and you're going to be on the sideline watching us rush. And you're going to be like, oh man, I messed up. But we ain't stunting. We're going to keep it on one and get our crown. Somebody say amen?
Amen.
We're going to get our crown. Amen. And you're going to be able to come out. And we're going to have our front. Are you here to tell me?
Amen.
So keep holding up if you want to, and God will disqualify you.
Yes.
Amen. Come on. Huh? Amen. Okay. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So see, God is good. That's somebody to contact. That contact you tell me about? Yeah, let me go ahead and get there. You can promise me that from the Praise the Lord, amen. It says, well, listen, y'all laughing. I know this is kind of funny, but this was a word to us to help us, amen.
Yes, yes.
We need, yeah, I'm telling y'all, if y'all hear me today, the apostle, I'm not trying to get the front down to build my name, but I want to get it down because I think it will uplift the property,
amen,
image,
yes,
and what we are doing here, right?
Amen.
I think it will give us a better outcome when people come to visit us. And when you bring friends in, you know, it could be embarrassing to tell your friend, no, you got to get in front of everybody and walk through. But it'd be like nice to go, baby, just go right on. In the back.
Amen.
Amen. Without getting a disturbance in the service. Y'all say amen.
Amen.
We already know now we have a quality. We have a nice building. We got it for free. We didn't pay for it. God gave it to us.
Amen.
Amen. And because we're under the grandfather clause, we can add on. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Amen. By being here, we're under the grandfather clause because we don't have enough parking to do a whole lot of stuff, right? But because we're under the grandfather clause, you always can remodel. But if you tear it down to the ground, you cannot put it back up.
Right.
Because then we fall under the new codes.
Right.
Amen. So, but because of that, amen, we can't put our bathrooms up front. We just got to get it done and have a mindset that we know we got to borrow some money, but we got to realize that it's okay to borrow money as long as you have a mindset you're going to pay it back.
That's right.
Amen. Amen.